this is Full Game Prometheus giving another full game recap. Once again, rolling with the run-heavy offense on offense. And I'm actually going to do this as strictly as an offensive gameplay. And the reason why is that basically this guy's his offense was just terrible. It was lob streaks. He just threw up balls. He didn't really have any kind of offense. So I figured to just save you guys the pain of watching this guy's offense. This is going to be a massive blowout against this guy. So I just want to forewarn you. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to focus on basically the offense we'll be running. This is actually, it's a strong, tight formation. You can find the strong, tight formation in the Jets, the Cardinals, and the also it's going to be in the run-heavy formation. So you're going to be seeing me use a lot of the single-back trio, which is a formation I've been using a lot in gameplay, and then obviously this this strong, tight. Now, what makes this formation tick is this basically pitch play. And let's see if we actually go with this guy. This guy didn't really have that great of defense. But you can see, if I always get blockers out in space, and if I got a good blocker as a wide receiver, it's going to give me opportunity to get to the sideline. So that's one of the reasons why I created a scheme out of that tight formation, the strong tight formation, just kind of beat my opponent up. Now this game, you're going to see me get over 100 rushing yards in the first half against this guy. He was a cupcake. He wasn't a very good player, but it's going to show you the effectiveness. Now if you take a look off the left hand side, you see how the defensive back was in the end. I did a little out route and then the corner route. There was just too much space. There wasn't enough defenders to be able to defend those routes, so I knew that I could actually go ahead and attack this guy. So second series here, got the ball back from a fairly quick. You can see his first quarter already. He actually blocked one of my field goals, but right here I'm just going to go ahead and go right back to this pitch play again. Try to contain the one defender, but look at this. I've got basically three blockers right here. A couple spin moves, able to go ahead and get a pass, get another 10 plus yard splash play on the ground. And then I would just go ahead and complement it with a run off to the left or nice little dive play. So a dive play actually picked me up some good yards. But what's one of the frustrating things when you're playing this game is that if you've got a guy that can effectively run against you, it's very hard to stop somebody if they can run the ball against you. It just opens up the rest of the offense for them, sets you up for some big plays. You start having to play gap protection, stuff like that. So right here is basically a little angle route with the fullback position, and this it's a high low read that I'll actually be going after. So going once again back to the running plays, switch into another play right here, which is kind of a crossing route play, and it's high low off to the right. You're gonna be looking off to the right, and then you can see the tight end position was just wide open for a 20-yard gainer or a little bit more if I were to broken a tackle right there. So just chipping along against this guy. Once again, he wasn't the best player in the game. Man, he was pretty bad per se. Got a nice little animation right there, able to go and shut me down before I got in the end zone. But he was playing cover two. I jumped into a play. I haven't really ran. What I did is I actually cleared up the cover two area, and then a little wheel route came underneath it, and I was able to go ahead and plug it back in for another touchdown. So up by two scores, feeling pretty good about myself. I get the ball back again. I guess this guy was just throwing interceptions left and right. Once again, back to the pitch play. You can see the box is full. He's got a bunch of people. He's actually playing the safety. But look at the blocking. The blocking is just so good with this run play. It's very, very effective, and then it's going to force your opponent to defend it. So right here, I go into another play, which is basically it's like a slide play. It's got play action. I got rid of the play action. You're going to drop it down, but this is man coverage, and I missed my reads. I probably should have dropped it down to the slide with the fullback, but I just missed my reads. So I just note he's playing mad. I figured he's just going to go back to this because this guy is a noob. He's a switch up his plays. And I go into basically a play that I know is going to beat man coverage, and it's going to be that slot receiver off the back inside. And sure enough, I'm going to get a completion and get the chains moving again. So back to the pitch play right here. I flip into the spot route, and let's see here. I've got the little wheel on the back inside. I've got a wing on the back inside. And then, let's see here. Went ahead and went back to the pitch because see how he's got his defenders pulled in? He just left that backside wide open. So I'm just going to go and pitch in on the right-hand side of the field. Because there's nobody out there, and his defender never even moved, didn't even take a gap, and I'm able to go ahead and get the ball down to the 1 yard line. So just chewing the clock down a little bit against him. once again, using this pitch out of the strong tight formation, motion my guy over to see if I can pull a defender. The defender sticks, and then I'm going to motion this guy back here. And you can see the defender actually follows, so that didn't really give me a good count on this side, and I think this is why he actually stops. But no, I actually get a good broken tackle animation to go and get into the end zone. So up 3 scores against my opponent. This guy's just lobbing balls up left and right. Once again, get the ball back from him. Because it's 4 minutes and 48 seconds, he threw another interception against me. So right here, I'm going into the slide play again. I streak up my tight end and block my running back because I don't want to get that slide animation because it carries over to the left. And I'm just going to go drop it down to this running back situation. And right here, I pick up another 15 yards in the area of the field. So it's just another good play to go and jump into. I think I've probably got a pitch going on right here because the count looks really good. And once again, you can see there's a bunch of blockers out there. I got pretty much blockers for every single player on defense over there. So unless he's sliding, scraping with his man defender, it's going to be very hard to stop that. And right here, I get I had guys my blocking on aggressive, so I give up a 10-yard situation. So I'm just going to go and jump into some other plays. So I think this guy was running a lot of zone coverage. So basically, I'm going to go and hit him with a lot of halfback draws. Just an easy way to go ahead and get easy yards down there. So once again, jumping into another halfback draw. I want to get a little bit closer and get tackled right there. We get it down to the 5-yard line, and now I'm going to go ahead and use my running play. He was using like a cover through shell or cover two shell, and right here I'm able to go and attack him with Jones right over the middle and just throw the ball, high ball the ball right over his defender. So up 4-0, get the ball back again. Like, that's one of the reasons I'm not showing you guys defense, because you would have been bored out of your mind. And right here, I actually get, I rub the defender, don't get the ball in the end zone, but you can see the hole is wide open. He scrunched up his line. Now I go back to the pitch again, and right here, just go ahead and plug the ball in to go up. So he gets a good play. On offense, he gets some points. I'm going to go right back. I think I'm going back to slide play right here. I'm going to streak up my tight end. I'm actually blocking my running, so streak up the hooper. And we're going to be looking underneath. That's our first read. Nobody out there. Let's just go and drop it down. Picked up 8 yards. Didn't spin. Didn't get the animation right there. But that's all right. So we're going to go right back to the pitch play. I've got an inside fullback dive that I didn't even bother showing because this guy's defense is really bad. But right here, actually, he gets a defender in the area, and my offensive line does not block. So this is another play that I've used in this scheme. This is just a passing play that I'm going to use. I'm looking for the wheel route by the running back. Nobody's in the area. I'm going to go drop it down, and I come up a little bit short. So 4th-and-1 situation. In this type of situation, I go ahead, drag up. This is a circle route. I'm going to drag up my outside receiver, and I'm looking high-low. Look at the drag. He follows the drag, and look at the high is wide open, and I'm able to go and get a nice little completion. And I think that's it for this guy. I think he's checked out after that. So basically 34-8 was the end score with this guy. This guy was not a very good player, but I wanted to highlight this offense, which is going to be the tight formation. Strong tight. It's got a really good pitch play. It's a phenomenal pitch play, and I built a whole scheme around it. And once again, you can find this in the Jets, the Cardinals, and then the heavy run heavy playbook. So to my subscribers, thanks for support, and until next time.